In this lecture, I'd like to say a few things that I believe will help you get in the right state of mind so that the time you spend on this project course is both effective and enjoyable. I'll keep it short because I know that you're eager to get started. Learning anything worthwhile takes time. Plan for your learning and set time aside for this specific activity in your busy schedule. Without dedicated time, you'll feel that you have to rush your way through the lectures, making the experience stressful. Learning under stress is not an effective way to learn. On the contrary, without planning to learn, you will not learn. Be in control of your learning through planning. I suggest that you plan to complete whole sections in one sitting. For most sections, you'll be able to comfortably complete them within 1 hour. Of course, if you have more time, consider scheduling enough time to complete more than one section. I find that I learn best when I can dedicate big uninterrupted blocks of time to a project, and I believe that this is true for most people. Big uninterrupted blocks of time also reduce the overall duration of the project because they allow you to reduce the time needed to change your mental context from whatever you happen to be doing prior to working on the project back to the context of the project. It goes without saying, but I'll say it anyway. Plan well to learn well. Each lecture has one or no more than two learning outcomes and an equal number of practical outcomes. Do not proceed to the next lecture until you have succeeded in both 1, understanding the learning outcomes of the lecture, and 2, achieving the practical outcomes of the lecture. If you proceed without completing the learning and practical outcomes of a lecture, you will hit an obstacle later and you'll have to come back and try again. Of course, it's okay to peek ahead, but be mindful that previous lectures will need to be completed first. What I've said so far applies to learning in general, but now I want to mention something specific to this project course. Even though the course is about building a Terrarium controller, you don't really need to set up a terrarium like the one in this photo. As I said in the earlier lecture titled "What is this course about?", the terrarium is just an excuse for learning how to use Node-RED and MQTT in my projects. If you don't want containers with water and soil on your workbench, you don't need to use them. You can still achieve the learning objectives using a potentiometer and DC motor in place of the soil humidity sensor and the water pump. Or you can find an alternative project to which you can adapt the course instructions. If you'd like to discuss your ideas and possible alternative projects, feel free to use the course community discussion space. Speaking of the community discussion space, I invite you to be an active member of the course's space on community.techexplorations.com. Learning is social, and social learning is the purpose of our community. Feel free to initiate discussions or to participate in existing discussions. Talk about your project implementation, roadblocks, alternative project ideas, components, hardware and software hacks, and anything else you think is relevant. I'm looking forward to seeing you in the community. Okay, that's it with the introductory lectures. It's now time to roll up your sleeves and start making. Are you ready? Please continue with the next section and lecture when you are.